From a small business to the Maryland House of Delegates, Kathy Szeliga has moved her way up the political ladder to become the highest-ranking Republican woman in Maryland. Now Szeliga wants to use her position to change the landscape of Washington.
So I think the part of the problem with Washington is people get there and they're beholden to lawyers and lobbyists and special interest groups because they're always worried about getting reelected.
The Republican candidate wants to move the Senate seat to the right and make certain that the person in that seat is a woman.
Just knowing that women, we bring a different perspective to the table.
Szeliga's disagreements with her opponent, Chris Van Hollen, range from the Affordable Care Act to the presidential race between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump.
I see people always, they're very dismayed on both sides of the aisle at the choices for president. I've been one to call out both Democrats and Republicans, and the citizens of Maryland, they deserve an independent voice.
The fight for the chance to represent Maryland is an uphill battle for Szeliga. She would become the first Maryland Republican in the Senate since Mac Mathias left in 1987. The Republican candidate is 30 points behind Van Hollen in the latest poll from the Washington Post and University of Maryland. Though Szeliga is running as a Republican, she wants to appeal to independents as well.
I am the proven independent voice, and if Maryland's voters are looking for an independent voice in the U.S. Senate, then Kathy Szeliga is the candidate they should support.
In Catonsville, Ann Perengott, CNS TV.